to Ixlon. Welcome to the UX20. My name is Dominic Martinson, and I would like to give you a short introduction into the UX20, Ixlon's universal X-ray cabinet for DR, digital radiography, and CT, computed tomography. First, I would like to give you a general overview of the system, and then we'll have a little closer look into the Gemini, Ixlon's intuitive user interface. While there are other videos that give you more information about DR and CT, this is meant to be a general overview of the system. So let's start and have a look at the different components. Here we have the operator console with the push buttons, the keyboard, and the joysticks to move the manipulator. Here you see the Gemini user interface. On your right side, we have the evaluation station for the reconstruction and analysis of the CT data. Here behind, you find the components of the PLC, but also the high voltage generator and the cooler. So you see everything is integrated into a compact and clean cabinet. Finally, we have the radiation tight cabinet with a big sliding door that gives you easy access into the inside of the system. So let's have a little closer look at the operator's console. This is the operator console of the UX20. First, we have the key switch for the X-ray safety, and then we have these joysticks and these two push buttons for the manipulator control. Then we have these three buttons for the inspection decision: accept, reject, or I don't know. On top, you see the Gemini user interface. On the left, lower side, we have the view from the surveillance camera. Nevertheless, we also have a LED glass window. This is the inside of the UX20. On the right side, you see the X-ray tube with a tube collimator and a removable Kappa filter. On the other side, there's the detector behind the plexiglass protection. Different tubes and detectors are available on request. The part manipulator is in the center. On the right, behind the door, you'll find a little shelf with more tube filters and the beam blocker that is used during tube maintenance. This is the surveillance camera for the overview image, which is displayed on the Gemini user interface. Pressing the door button will close the cabinet door. Once closed, the part will automatically move into the inspection position. The UX20 manipulator has 5 axes: rotation, tilting, magnification, a horizontal axis across the beam, and the vertical axis. To begin, enter your username to log into the Gemini user interface. The different user levels define your rights to create or modify inspection programs. If you want to have all rights, you log in as administrator. This is the Gemini user interface. On top left, you see the different operators for the collision protection, the X-ray parameters, the detector settings, and the manipulator. Below, you find the live image of the surveillance camera. The big window on the center right normally shows the X-ray image, but since X-rays aren't switched on yet, it is empty. The health monitor quickly informs you about the status of the different system components. The yellow warning for the X-ray indicates that tube maintenance must be carried out due to the system having been switched off for a longer period of time. Also, image quality is marked yellow since a detector calibration needs to be chosen, which can be done later. After clicking the X-ray warning, a new window pops up for the tube maintenance. Before switching on the X-rays, the UX20 prompts you to mount the beam blocker in order to protect the detector during the tube maintenance. After this is done and confirmed, the door closes and the procedure starts automatically. The required time depends on the number of days the system was switched off. When the tube maintenance has finished, the door opens and the UX20 prompts you to remove the beam blocker. At the end, you simply confirm and you're ready to go. The icons on the top left give direct access to the system parameters such as X-ray settings, manipulated position or others. You can adjust the size of the different windows to suit your needs. Depending on the inspection task, it can be useful to move the part close to the X-ray tube or to the detector. The collision protection allows to do so while respecting the safety of both the UX20 and the inspection item. You see now the schematic view of the inner cabinet with a 3D model of the U-arm and the part manipulator. The cylinder on top of the 3-jaw chuck sample holder represents the part. The diameter of this 3-jaw chuck is 300 mm. In this case, the part does not stick out horizontally. Therefore, it is safe to set the diameter of the part to 300 mm. If you are unsure of the exact height of the part, make a point to set the height value of the collision protection volume higher than the actual part. This can be done by moving the slider to the right. That's it! Now you have set the collision protection and can use the joysticks to move the part in any direction, knowing that the UX20 takes care of the safety. A click on the green button at the bottom switches on the X-rays. Now you see the X-ray image of the part. To move it, simply use the joysticks. Another option is to click somewhere in the image. Then the part moves so that this spot gets into the center of the image. The rotary knob on the control panel allows you to reduce the manipulator speed. Yet another way to move the part is to drag the sliders on the left or enter the number value of the desired position. No matter which way you choose to move the part, you can be assured the collision protection is still active. Now you have seen how easy and intuitive it is to work with the UX20. Pixlon's universal X-ray and CT inspection cabinet, ideally suited for medium to large cast parts. You would like to know more? No problem. Just contact us via the contact form on our website. We're looking forward to give you a live demo, either online or at our customer centers around the world.